up, Soul Fam? How you guys doing? I'm on my way to my mom's house. Usually I'm on my way to my dad's house. Now I'm on my way to my mom's house. She had knee surgery. A whole new knee. She actually had her knee scraped out a couple months ago and it made it worse and it caused some sort of scar tissue or something. I don't know. I don't know knee science. So the doctor said, oh, you need a whole new knee. I think it's all about money. You know, they made money on scraping her knee and now they made more money on giving her a whole new knee. They should have just gave her a new knee in the first place and she would have been all good for the summer. In my opinion, I would have waited until after summer to get my knee done because now you can't enjoy the summer. It's my understanding that it takes a long time for you to, you know, recover from that surgery, but we shall see. She's a strong woman. She'll bounce back pretty quick. She seemed to be getting around pretty good yesterday, so we'll see how she's getting around today after all that, you know, anesthesia and all that good stuff wears off. You always feel kind of good when you come home from surgery because you still got some of that stuff lingering. But when all of those, you know, medicines come out of your body, then you know how you really feel. Anyways, so how are you guys feeling? The energy is insane. It's bananas. The Russian chart was offline for a couple of days. It was a blackout. When they have a blackout, I feel like they're hiding something. I don't know what, but I mean, the way we are receiving energy, a lot of us know we're receiving energy because we can feel it. And the last couple of days, my body has been vibrating with energy. Like when I have a lot of energy in my body, it just feels like like a hum of energy just like flowing through all of my body. And that's how I felt for the last couple of days. And then I get these surges of feeling very tired. And I think it's just because your body's trying to acclimate to holding so much energy. And you know, just after a while it's taxed out and it's like, I need rest. We're like these, you know, outdated generators, and we can only hold so much energy for so long before we burn out. And the new, you know, the new humans that are being born, the new souls coming into their new avatar body is going to be born into this energy, so they won't have to acclimate to it because they're born into it. We were born into a different resonance, a 7.83. So as the resonance of the planet rises and changes, there's all of these side effects that we feel, and the earth feels it, we feel it, you know, nature feels it. So for us, you know, and you know, I was born in 78. So anybody that was born before me and is a little, I'll just wait for all the cars to go by. And for anybody that's older, like maybe like my mother, my father, my grandparents, the resonance, they may find it harder to acclimate to the resonance because their body just can only process energy a certain way, and they've lived a certain amount of years and reached a certain age that when the resonance started to shift, the age and the way that their body is programmed, it's maybe a little bit more challenging and harder to acclimate. That's why some people, not all, but some people, when these resonance changes happen, these side effects kick in and causes all this disruption in your nervous system and creates these diseases that turn into disease, could cause death. And even with your heart, it could cause, you know, strokes, heart attacks, stuff like that, because of the resonance changing and your body and your nervous system not being able to acclimate to it because it's just not used to it. And then there's those of us that are a little bit younger that, you know, some of us are able to just acclimate and some of us are not. And then the younger you are, the easier it is for you to reside in the energy of the planet. But I feel like something happened with that blackout. Even the chart even went in on the geomagnetics, went into red, yellow, red, back down to the green, I believe. But I feel like I think the chart is back online because there's a huge spike coming in right now. I seen some whiteout on there, but I don't know if it stopped there and then blacked out again. I'm not really sure. But we are approaching the solstice. We're in eclipse season. There's a lot of energy happening out there in the cosmos and the planets and the sun and the moon and all of that. So yeah, there's just a lot of stuff happening. And I want to talk about my dream last night, but while I'm talking about the cosmos and the planets and stuff, I've been hearing my guides keep telling me to tell you guys to check out sidereal astrology. It's important. I don't know if it's important for all of you or if there's a certain handful of you that need to hear this, or maybe there's one person that I need to reach out to give you this information, but it's to shy away from Western astrology and dig your feet in. I see roots, root yourself into true sidereal astrology. And it's something that I've been looking into. In my Western astrology, I'm a Leo, Leo Virgo something, I don't remember because I haven't really paid much attention to it. I just know that my sun sign in Western is Leo and I'm Virgo, and I think maybe, I don't know, Aries or Pisces or something like that. But in sidereal, I am actually Cancer, Cancer Pisces Leo. And I've been reading a lot about myself in the sidereal birth chart. You need to know where you were born, the exact time you were born. It's very important. And it just seems so crazy accurate for me. And especially with all this new energy coming in, it makes a lot of sense. Even in my numerology chart, it makes a lot of sense. Everything's starting, I found the puzzle pieces before with the Western astrology, but with this sidereal astrology, my pieces are actually fitting in, and it's like a door opened for me. It's like I solved something and something opened up. It's like my prize and I get to move on to the next thing. There's a lot of great connection. I have a really good connection with spirit, and I've been doing some card readings on myself, meditating on myself. I've started to rework on my, doing my yoga and stuff like that. I fall off, I get back on, I fall off, I get back on. But, something really clear came through from spirit, and I gotta work back doing my yoga and heal myself. The only way that back pain is gonna go away is for me to heal myself. And I know that you have the power to heal yourself, but there was a moment, I may have shared this in my recent video, I thought I did, where I felt pissed off because, I know we have the power to heal ourselves, but I felt like it just wasn't happening fast enough for me. And it was just irritating that, I have to remind myself we're on this earth plane, third dimension, hasn't shifted for everybody into the fourth or fifth. So we're still lingering in this third dimension. So everything runs very slow, and it's like, we're still governed by time. And wherever I came from before, everything must have went like this for me, because that's how I expect it to go for me here. And I could feel that I can do this, but seeing that I'm not getting the results made me second guess what I can do. And then I was reminded, it's the timeline that I'm on. It's the place where I'm at this moment, where I'm lingering, where I'm anchored in, but it doesn't mean that I still, oh, did I kill it? I don't know if I ran over a squirrel. Why do squirrels and chipmunks always run across the street? Oh my God. I feel really bad because I'm not sure if I hit it or not. Shit like that really irritates me because, you know, we share this planet with them, and these roads were put into place with these big ass vehicles, and it's just not right. It really isn't. Wow, that really knocked me off what I was saying, but so healing is not happening as fast as I want it to, but I was reminded that I do have the power. I just have to work with the power that I have, with the power that I'm resonating in, or, you know, residing in. And, you know, yoga was brought to my attention, you know, moving your body, doing yoga and breath work. And it's true. Even though it's a slow healing process, it's an accurate healing process. For me, it is, at least. So I've been guided to work on my root chakra for a week and then move up from there. So I started it yesterday, did it again today, and I feel this feeling. I don't want to talk too much about it because I don't like want to jinx it, but I do feel something different, and I'm happy with what I feel. But that's what I wanted to bring to your attention before I moved on to my strange dream. So I feel like I was guided to tell you guys about the sidereal astrology and then share that, you know, also share that little tidbit about my healing, moving your body. Even though I'm stiff as a board and I don't feel like doing yoga because everything just hurts. But I mean, once you move past the pain a little bit, it kind of like, I don't know, it's like yoga lubricates your joints. Even though it hurts at the beginning of it, by the end of it, it feels a little bit better. Move with grace and have no expectations. Before I had a lot of expectations, and I wanted to be able to do crazy inversions and be a yogi master and do all those cool, like, stand on your head and, you know, be very flexible. But I have to live with the fact that right now I'm not that flexible, and maybe I never will be, and that's okay. I also had to revisit the way I feel towards other. I was, you know, slacking on my spiritual discipline. So I'm rereading my journal and rereading what I wrote about spiritual discipline. So I'm taking that into consideration and practicing some of those affirmations, and just working on myself. I feel like I let myself go a lot of things, you know, spiritually, when it comes to being disciplined and living with people that are not spiritually disciplined, and you fall into their ways of judgment and how they feel and ego and stuff like that, is not very helpful. But, you know, I can't just point my finger and say it's your fault that I'm like this, you know, because it's me. It's all about me and how I carry myself, how I speak, how I think, how I feel. And it's not easy, especially if you choose to be married to somebody that does not share the same way that you think or feel. But other than that, everything's great. Now I want to talk to you guys about the strange dream I had last night. So last night I went to bed about 10 o'clock. And when I made my way upstairs, my husband bought me this really cool salt lamp. And it has meditation on it. It has like music and sound so that you can sleep, like waterfall, thunderstorm, meditation. It has a guided meditation on there. It has a few cool options on there. But anyways, so he took his rainstorm alarm clock out of the room because that's how he sleeps. It's how we sleep. We sleep listening to the sounds of his alarm clock, which is usually the rainstorm or the, you know, the rain or whatever. So the salt lamp had that option. So I noticed that he didn't plug it in. So when I went to bed, I plugged it in, set it up. I laid in bed and I started to doze off. But I don't know really how long I dozed off. Maybe it was 5 minutes, 10 minutes, maybe it was an hour. I don't know. I was listening to one of Dolores Cannon's old conferences. I like listening to her because the sound of her voice is soothing. She's like a grandmother to me. That's how I feel. And grandma was talking, telling me a story, and Gabby went to sleep. That's how I feel. And that's what I did. So then, I don't know, I woke up. Something woke me up. A presence of something woke me up. And I was uneasy for a minute, and I looked, I felt for my husband. He was sleeping, and I was like, okay, it wasn't him. And I felt somebody was in the room with me. I don't feel like they necessarily left them. They may have, and it was their energy lingering, but it was very strong, and it really felt like they were still there. And then I noticed this pulsing, this vibrating pulsing going through my whole entire body, like buzzing and pulsing. It was really strong. I don't know if that was my psychic senses in that woke me up to tell me something was there. I have this feeling that there is this strange alien presence, that it's around me, or it's going to make itself known to me. I'm not quite sure if I was abducted. I mean, there is a majority of us that get abducted and will never even know about it. But maybe I was about to, or maybe I did. I don't know. It's just really, really, really strange the way I felt. I wasn't really scared, but I was kind of like aware that something was there and a little uncomfortable because whatever was there, I didn't recognize it. So the energy signature that was in the room with me was something that I didn't recognize. And then the radio, as I was going back to sleep, like I didn't want to turn my back because I felt like somebody was there, but I couldn't see them. And I felt like if I turned my back, like they were going to grab me or touch me. I don't know. It was just a really weird feeling. And so I kept my face towards that way, but I put the blanket over my face because it was just a strange feeling. Like I felt like I was being stared at. And then I heard talking. And then I pulled the blanket down to listen, and the radio, the waterfall, I heard like somebody was talking on a CB radio, and I could only make out certain words here and there, and it was just like, and I wish I could remember the words. Last night I recognized some of the words, but it wasn't, I don't know, it sounded like people were talking on a CB radio and it was work related or something. I don't know. And they sound a little serious. Sounded like maybe, couldn't even tell you. I want to tell you that it sounded like a landing pad, like when the pilot talks to the people when they're about to land. It sounded something like that. But I don't know if that's what it was. I don't want to say that that's what it was. It was strange. And then I was listening, and I had that really weird feeling again come over me, and I was just like, oh my God, I can hear them, what they're talking about, but I can't really understand what they're saying. And then I just stood there and listened and listened and listened until I calmed down enough to go back to sleep, and I just drifted off to sleep. And then at 12 o'clock, I had this urge to pee like real bad, and I didn't want to get out because I felt like somebody was in the room. I felt like there was more than one person. And I felt like I would have walked past them to go to the bathroom. So I was really nervous about getting out of bed. But I finally did. And then when I came back to bed, it was like I did a hop, like a quick hop into the bed and pulled the blankets up over me like there was a monster in the room or something. You know, I felt like, you know, how you feel when you're a kid and you're afraid of the dark. So I get back into bed and I hear it again. All of a sudden I'm drifting off to sleep, and then I start hearing the talking again. I'm like, no way. So I snuggle up next to my husband because I'm like, I don't know what to make of this. And I was like, I don't want to be abducted. I don't know. I was just like, you know, the dark can make you feel scared. So I'm like, okay, I'm a child. And then I finally fell asleep, and then I started to wake up about, I think I woke up about 3:40 a.m., but I woke up from a really fucked up dream, like really crazy. In my dream, my nose was bleeding profusely. Is that the right word? Did I say it right? It was just bleeding, and it was heavy and chunky, and I couldn't stop the blood. And then there was somebody there just like giving me a tissue, and they were telling me something, And whatever they were telling me, the blood started to go away a little. And then as I was dabbing my nose, the blood was less and less. And then all of a sudden, whoever was with me went like this, and a door opened, and I saw a woman in a bathtub bathing. And then I dabbed my nose and the blood was gone. And then I dabbed my nose again, the blood was gone. And then I was like, this relief, this feeling of relief came over my body, and I felt, I wasn't scared that my nose was bleeding, and I felt like, okay, everything was good. And then the woman stood up, and when she stood up, she was naked. And I was like, you know, like, what? And as she walked towards me, the woman was my brother's wife, and I saw her completely naked, and there were certain things that stuck out on her body. And I seen her curly hair, I seen all of her, you know, privates, I seen how she maintained herself down there. I know this may sound like TMI, I don't know why I had this dream, it sounds really fucked up, but there's something symbolic about it, and I just can't figure it out. And when she walked by me, her eyes connected with me, and she looked at me, but like, the feeling I felt was defeat. Like, she was defeated or something. And then I woke up, and I was just laying in the bed, and I was just like, what the fuck was that? Why would I dream that? And it felt so real, like real. And it's been sticking with me all morning. It is 10:38 right now. 8 plus 3, 11. Ah! The number 11, validation. But you know, it just was crazy. And while I was laying in bed though, I was like, did she put a voodoo on me or something? I felt like maybe she did something to me, but whatever she did to me broke. Like, if she casted, it's like she casted something over me, and whatever she casted or whatever spell she was trying to do or had me under, or my, you know, had this control of me, it was broken. And I even felt like this feeling of, wow, I'm free. Now, shoot, I missed the street. So, like, for those of you that don't know and that have not been following me, quick, you know, I'll speed you up to date. So, I've had this issue with my siblings. Actually, they've had this issue with me, and it has to do with her. I don't know if you've ever heard of a handler before. But I feel like she is my brother's handler, and she's also now my sister's handler, and she controls them, and she controls the family. Like, she has this way of controlling people, and she uses kindness, and she does very nice things, but she doesn't do it with love. And that's how she gains this control to do these things. And I made a video a while back, victim control dynamic, and being gaslit and all that shit. And I had this thing where we were beefing and all that stuff. And then I forgave, and, you know, we started all talking again because my dad was sick and yada, yada, yada. And then all of a sudden she didn't like that my brother was getting close to me and my sister. We were calling each other, talking to each other. You know, we started to rekindle this relationship, and she didn't like that. And then she told my mom that she wasn't ready to mend things yet. And then all of a sudden my brother and my sister both pulled back, and we stopped talking. And then all of a sudden the feud started again, and words were said because, you know, you hurt my feelings, I hurt yours. I tried to be nice, but then all of a sudden my ego came out, and it wasn't being very nice. My sister attacked my daughter, like, verbally, and it just got ugly again. You know, family drama. So here we are again, where we were back in 2016, where none of us were talking, and, you know, they don't, you know, visit my mom or my dad. My brother does it in secrecy. If they ever watch this video, it won't be so secret anymore. But I love my brother and my sister. And so a while ago, well, June, as of June, I had this whole surrendering thing. I feel like I told you guys this, but I may not have posted the video. So I did this whole surrendering thing again because I was, you know, I fell off, you know, my spiritual discipline and went back to my old egotistical ways. I haven't been recording videos. I haven't been in the right state of mind. I've been, you know, healing and, you know, just working shit out, facing my shadows and, you know, realigning my chakras, you know, all that kind of great stuff. And, you know, just figuring myself out because I gave my power away and I didn't like the way it feels. And then, so like the first week of June, I said, you know what? Fuck this. I fucking surrender. But the way I felt after I said it was like it was a piece of surrendering that I was holding on to. And I actually let it go. And I forgive. I forgive her. I forgive her even if she's soulless or even if she has a soul. I forgive her. I send her love and life, love and light and luck and blessings that she can be a better person or not. And even though I can't tell her I forgive her, I said it mentally and I put it out there and I said, our contract is null and void. We cannot do this. I'm done. And I forgive my brother and my sister, and I just forgive everybody because it's easier, even though it's hard to forgive people, it just feels easier right now because fighting is so much more harder and it takes so much more energy. And when I did that, let me tell you, I feel better. I feel like a weight has been lifted off of my shoulders and I feel like a new person. I feel like the person I was when I was making videos and talking to you guys and sharing stuff with you guys. And I feel like that dream I had last night was maybe validation that maybe my ego died and my spirit is set free, or maybe the spell broke or the contract really between us is over. That's why that defeated that she felt defeated or something. But I don't know if any of you guys have any like input about, I don't know if there's anybody out there that watches my videos that are good at interpreting dreams and, you know, are they good with, you know, dream symbolism and stuff like that. But if you are, please share with me. And if you feel that it's too personal to put down in the comments, shoot me an email. I normally put my email, well, I try to put my email at the end of all my videos. Well, guys and gals and souls and star seeds, light warriors, light workers. I am at my mom's house. My video is 28 minutes long. This is the longest witchy vlog probably ever. Not witchy vibe video, but witchy vlog. But yeah, so I kind of just wanted to share all that with you guys as I drove to my mom's house, and it just feels good to talk about it out loud, and it just feels good to share with you guys. I feel like somebody else out there needed to hear me speak because it helped them in some way. And, you know, if it resonates with you, that's great. If it didn't, then, you know, whatever. You should have just, you know, ended the video a long time ago. If I triggered you, then there's something that you need to work on within yourself. You know, whatever it is that you see within me that you didn't like is something that you need to work on within yourself to heal. So I hope that this video was healing or helpful or validating, or it resonated in some way. And I just want to thank you guys for listening to me and supporting me. I thank you guys for emailing me and checking up on me. If you guys ever want to just chat with me, you guys can friend me on Instagram. It's really probably the easiest way to chat with me on Instagram, through the messenger. But, yeah, I love you guys and I'm grateful for you guys. I'm still doing tarot readings, angel card, past life readings, numerology. I still have merch. We are making cosmic history. I have that merch. I have Witchy Vibes 11 merch. And I'm creating some more stuff. And I am starting to get back into video making, but right now I'm just being guided to go through all of my journals. I don't know what I'm looking for, but I'm looking for something. There's some knowledge that I'm looking for. It's a puzzle piece that I'm looking for. And once I find it, I'll share it with you guys. And I don't know. Keep your eyes to the sky. I feel like something bigger, something's happening. And it's going to be shown to all of us very soon. And I feel like I'm picking up on that energy. And maybe it is something, you know, alien, and they're here and they came into my room last night. I don't know. I know that sounds really crazy to say that out loud, but yeah, I don't know. There's a lot of things happening. We are in a very high energy month, the month of June. A lot of eclipse energy. We were just bombarded with moon energy, lunar. We had the lunar eclipse, the solar eclipse. Now we're approaching solstice, and so much. Where the planets are stationed, the resonance of the planet is changing. There's just so much going on. So you guys, just be kind to yourself, be kind to others, stay hydrated, love yourself. And if you want, follow me on Instagram. I'm trying to share my affirmations there for those of you that, you know, are suffering with ego, that you may find that it's a little bit challenging to move forward with your spiritual discipline. I'm working on mine again. And if you kind of need help with yours, if you follow me, I'll share my journey with you guys there to help raise your vibration as well. All right, I really gotta go. I love you. Mwah. Bye.